Bookshelves have always been lacking, so here's a way to spruce them up with 1.13 data packs. Hey guys, it's Chad. We've done videos on bookshelves a lot here, trying to add any functionality to the normal bookshelf block in Minecraft because it looks like it should be so amazing, but really it is just a static block that can't do anything. Well, Chuck has made a data pack and a resource pack that totally changes the look and feel and usefulness of bookshelves. So let's check it out.
So here we are inside of Minecraft, and the first thing that you need to make sure is that you are running some version of 1.13 Minecraft snapshots. I'm currently on 18W14B, but this should work with future versions. Next, you're going to have to install the data pack and the resource pack, and because we really haven't had any experience doing that, I'm going to show you how to do that. So right here, this is what I downloaded and unzipped. It's actually still in the zip folder, but we're going to unzip it and unarchive it in just a bit. You have an optional resource pack. You have the bookshelf data pack and then the bookshelf resource pack. And then you have the install.txt and readme.txt. Install is just basically how to install it, which I'll show you right now. And readme is the recipes and things like that, which we're going to get into as well. So first, navigate to your Minecraft folder. I'm on a snapshot, so this is it for me, where it has your saves and resource packs. And you're going to take the resource packs, and you could do both. Like it says, this is an optional. It'll just show up as a spawn egg if you don't install this resource pack. It's not a really big deal. But just drag those folder over into your resource packs folder, and that should be there. They're there and going to work just great. Next is move over to the save that you want to install the shelves on. And I'm going to use this one, the 18W14B, and we're going to take this data pack and move it into the data packs folder. If there isn't a data packs folder, it might be a good clue that you're not on a snapshot and that you need to be on a snapshot. And that's it. Now over on Minecraft, go into your options, your resource packs, and push both of these over to be part of your resource pack list. And go ahead and jump into the world that you would like to craft your bookshelves in. And that you install the bookshelf like data pack on. Now that you are in the game, one thing that you can quickly do is go to data packs, list, and enabled, and that'll just tell you which ones are enabled. And look, this bookshelves one is enabled, which is really, really nice. This adds a few functions, which is really cool. So you can do function, and you can see all these crazy functions. First, you're going to type out bookshelf, and you can actually do give shelves, and this will give you all of the shelves. You can see these show up as little scrolls, and that's what that one resource pack was, to turn those from spawn eggs into scrolls. So you can easily figure out if everything is running correctly that way. But if you were in survival, oh, it looks like I need some food. Oh my gosh. You would throw down a crafting table. First, craft some planks. And then you can craft a shelf just like this, where you have the planks on one side and the slabs on another. And that gives you these little guys right here. And you can see that as I put them into my inventory, they kind of, it noticed that they were there, and then it regave me a new one. You almost kind of like have to have a version of it that isn't quite correct. Like you can see that they're like brown, and then when you give them to yourselves, they'll transfer into the correct version. And then all you do is go and place them onto whatever block you want, just like that. You can kind of see the quick animation that it's doing. You can either put them on the ground right there or against the back of the block that you want, and you can even make corner bookshelves. Oh, whoops, I just put it on the bookshelf. Come to me. There we go. You have to really aim, make sure you're hitting that hitbox. And there you go. Now you have a corner shelf that's just adding two bookshelves onto each other. Switching into the creative game mode just so that we can have a little bit more fun. There is so much that you can actually add onto these bookshelves. And you can do all of the various different colors that they have. So let me just show those off. Here they are all kind of lined up. You have your basic oak and spruce and birch and jungle and acacia, dark oak. You even have bricks and stone bricks. So lots of different types of bookshelves. And remember, this isn't modded at all. This is just in normal Minecraft, which is pretty awesome. Next, we're going to give ourselves some books. We're going to give ourselves some normal books, book and quill, some enchanted books, and we can also give ourselves some, paper as well. And all you have to do is take a book, hold it in your hand, and you have six different slots that you can set these guys into. Now, what is really, really cool is that there are different kind of textures. I guess not for book and quill, but let's switch out a book and quill for one of these enchanted books. And you can see that the books actually change just a bit. And that is because there are different textures for different types of books. So let me go and grab some more enchanted books just to show you. Not only are the normal books a different texture, the enchanted books are a different texture. So those kind of, you can see the difference there, but also paper is a different texture. And you can see that these, this is kind of just like books without any type of, binding or anything like that. But then also you can add other items into, I don't know if I'll be able to do a bow just because normally you kind of like draw that back like you're going to attack. And you can even do potions and things like that. So let's throw some potions in there, maybe some mutton, a sword. There we go. Switch that one out there. I don't know if a helmet is going to work. It may not work with, it's not going to work with armor. Let me try it with the bow. Oh, it did work. Oh, it's a little broken through the shelf there. Okay, well, let's switch that out there. So you can put all sorts of different things onto the shelves, which really pull off some really neat looking stuff. Okay, so say you're in this situation where you're building out your little house and you decide that, you know what, I don't want my shelves right down here anymore. How are you going to get rid of them? Because you can't break them with your fist. Well, you will need to make yourself a few hammers. So it looks like cave spiders, but in fact, they are shelf hammers. Just like this, and you can see you can only destroy a bookshelf if it is empty. So once you have an empty bookshelf, whoops, get out of there. Then you take your hammer and click on the block that it is on with it. And there you go. So it goes away. So you have to make sure that the hitbox for that block is there. And then you place them down. And so you can place down a whole bunch of them. And then if I, get out of there. If I wanted to add sort of some shelving down here at the bottom, then you can easily do that. And so that is how you would break a shelf, is use a hammer, which is just gunpowder. All you have to do is give yourself just one gunpowder. We'll make 16 hammers. So to kind of wrap up, I just wanted to show off kind of what you could pull off in your own world if you were to do this, where we have a few bookshelves. A lot of this is just paper and books and things like that that are stored. But we do have a few. There you go. This is a written book by myself. You can see that I've written, I got to pick that back up. I've written some fantastic things in this book. Yes, just for safekeeping, I'll set it right there. We also have some normal books, and I think this is an enchanted book. This may be also a written book. Oh, yeah, that's just another written book. But anyway, you could store my bedrock. I'll just put my bedrock right there, you know, that I mined just a little bit before. But it looks really, really cool. It functions really, really nicely. And I think that this is a very nice addition to a game to add functional bookshelves.
Hope you enjoyed this. In the description down below, there is a link to Chuck Chuck's original video, which that video includes links to the data pack download. So check that out in the description down below. Big thanks to Chuck Chuck for creating this awesome, cool resource. Thanks so much for watching this episode of OMG Craft to you. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please leave a comment down below letting me know your thoughts, and make sure you subscribe to future videos on OMG Craft to get tips, tricks, tutorials, and spotlights. See you next time on OMG Craft. Bye.